Wayne Carpenter says he knew his mother was dead once the tornado passed through Yazoo City because she would not answer when he called her name.
The 7-year-old's mother, Nikki Carpenter, was killed Saturday when a tornado sent their mobile home tumbling. The mother of three died while shielding her children with her own body. Tonight, her boys are at home with their grandfather recovering. 60 WAPT's Joseph Pleasant visited the boys at home and shows us how they are doing tonight.
Right, Nikki Carpenter's 2-year-old son, Ethan, was just released from the hospital late this afternoon. Now, he hasn't talked about the storm yet, but his brother Lane does. The 7-year-old has vivid memories of that horrible event.
Lane is only 7, but has experienced something most of us never will. And one day, he lost his mother, Nikki Carpenter, and his home. He won't talk about it with us, but he told his grandfather.
They received a phone call, and his mother ran down the hall, was tossing pictures and things off the wall so there wouldn't be any debris flying around. She got them on the floor, covered them with pillows, and got on top of them.
In the next few seconds, a tornado tossed their mobile home more than 100 feet. It was left shattered with Carpenter, Blaine, 2-year-old Ethan, and 1-year-old Austin trapped inside.
He was pretty sure that his mom didn't make it because he kept calling her and she wouldn't answer. And he could hear his 2 little brothers hollering and screaming.
Lane has had nightmares since that experience. He also has a fractured hand. His brother Ethan has damage to his ear. He had surgery on Sunday. Austin has cuts on his legs and arms, battered and bruised, but their family is glad they are alive.
Come take time and some miraculous help for us to move forward.
Bradshaw has taken Carpenter's pictures down for now because Lane cries when he sees them. Bradshaw says the boys will get counseling, so will the rest of the family.
Carpenter's grandfather is asking people to donate money to a special bank account for the boys. Instead of sending flowers, the accounts are for Ethan, Lane, and Austin at the Capaya Bank. The money will be used for the boys' education. Bradshaw told us this afternoon that Carpenter's son's education was very important to their mother.